Final Cut Pro 10.4 gives you three different methods of color correcting your video. We've previously looked at color correction using the color board and color wheels. Today, we're going to take a look at color correcting your video using color curves. Hey guys, what's up? This is Serge and welcome back to my channel. Down in my timeline, I have two copies of the same clip. The first clip is the original clip, and the second copy has a color wheels correction applied to it. We'll use this later to compare the two corrected clips to see the difference. So let's select our first clip and set up for color correction. First, let's hide our browser by pressing Ctrl Command 1 and bring up the video scopes by pressing Command 7. Next, in the inspector, select Color Inspector and from the drop-down menu select Color Curves. Here we have four curves, one for Luma or brightness channel and a curve for each color channel, red, green, and blue. First, let's switch to the LumaScope waveform in the video scopes and take a look at the Luma curve. Over on the bottom here, you have your input values, with this side being shadows and this side is highlights. And on the side is your output values. When no adjustments are made to the clip, you have a straight diagonal line here. Now first, let's bring down the shadows to bring a waveform down to zero. Grab the shadows control point and drag it over to the right while watching the waveform. There is some true blacks in the clip, so drag it over until the waveform traces touch zero. Now let's grab the highlights control point and drag it over to the left until our waveform traces reach 100, maybe even a little bit more. Everything in between these two points is used to control the midtones. But instead of just having one control like the color wheels, we can add as many control points as necessary for more precise adjustments. To add a control point, simply click on this line and drag it up or down to adjust it. For this clip, let's spread out our dynamic range by adding two points and adjusting them for a gentle S-curve. Now let's compare this clip to the same clip with the same adjustments made in color wheels. Notice how the clip adjusted with color wheels has much more saturated colors. When you adjust exposure using color wheels, both exposure and saturation are affected. But when you adjust it using color curves, only the Luma channel or exposure is affected, while the color saturation does not change at all. To adjust saturation using color curves, you have to adjust each color channel individually. For example, to give the sky more color, scroll down to the blue channel. Most of our sky will be in the highlights, so let's grab the highlights point and drag it over to the left. But wait, doing this affects the entire line, so blue is added to everything, not just highlights. That's not what we want. I'll reset this correction by clicking the hooked arrow up here. To only adjust the highlights in the blue channel, we need to lock in our midtones and shadows by adding another control point. I'll add one right here, and add and drag up another point to give our sky a little more blue color. Next, let's adjust our grass to make it a little bit greener. If you look in the video scopes, you can see most of the green grass lies in the midtones. So let's add a control point on the green curve and add a point on each side to lock our shadows and highlights. Now grab the middle control point and move it up a bit to give the grass a little bit more color. And last, let's add a bit of color to our trail. The last two adjustments were easy because we had both blue and green color curves, but which one do we adjust for the trail color? Fortunately, you're not locked down to just the three primary colors. If you click on the drop-down menu beside the color name, you can select any color you want, and that's the hue that will be adjusted. Alternately, if you're not 100% sure of the color, you can use the color sampler tool. Click on the eyedropper in the top right, and click and drag out a color sample. Final Cut Pro selects the correct color of your sample area with a vertical line indicating the brightness of the selected area. Let's click on the line to add a control point and add another one about halfway down to lock in the shadows. Click and drag up on the middle control point to add a bit of orange color to the trail. Finally, to make this clip a little more vibrant, it could use an overall increase in saturation. Doing this with color curves can be very difficult, but what we can do is combine this color curves correction with a color wheels correction. Click on the drop-down menu beside Color Curves 1 and select Color Wheels. This adds another color correction to your clip, where you can use the master wheel to bump up the overall saturation of your clip. Let's go back to the video inspector, where we can toggle both these corrections off and on to see the before and after. So, as you can see, using color curves to correct your clip gives you much more precision and control, but it's a very different correction method. Sometimes it may be necessary to combine multiple correction methods to achieve the exact look you're going for. Try this out and let me know what you think in the comments below. If you're new here, check out the rest of my channel for more Final Cut Pro tutorials. New videos released weekly, so make sure to hit the subscribe button so you don't miss them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week.